Ready, everybody? Cameras rolling. And action. Satisfaction we get from dancing, just the fact itself of moving to the music, and even performing to people, it's special feel it gives us when it is good. Most of the time it's yucky, most of the time it's horrible, and when we usually joke with our friends and dancers, it's why do we like masochists? We go there, and most of the time competition sucks, but those thrilling moments when we can, it's like meditation, like doing yoga. I don't know, you go to a different place, this is it. And then you come back and it's like being in trance and you still kind of remember it. Special thrill. And I can't say winning is not thrilling. Yes, it's pleasant. Getting the check and getting the trophy and standing up there on the podium, that's nice. Maybe one day, maybe that's a hope. One day we can stand on the podium with the American anthem playing, representing US and winning some major world championship. We ended up dancing 6-8 hours a day straight, just dance, besides everything else we do, and being on the feet and moving. And then once people ask us, don't you want to go dance for fun? I mean, come on, what fun are you talking about? I want to get to bed, or I want to get to the hot tub. That's all I care about at the moment.
Let's get loud. like dance with Igor because he would shake me out of my dress or something. When I want to have fun and I want to dance socially, I want to just like put a nice dress on, like long dress, high heels, and just be able to just move, not that swivels, turns. And Igor wants to just take girl and just throw her, turn her, whatever, drop. And no, it's too scary. Time when we dance together, he always start doing, okay, keep your frame, okay, squeeze that side, okay, use your muscles, and I hate this.
Okay, all right.
I don't want to stand like this.
Yes, but we're practicing the studio, and here I have this perfect lady with the perfect technique, doing everything right. Now she's trained, she knows everything. And we go later to the nightclub or wherever we go to dance socially, and all of a sudden, she thinks she's off duty. And then she goes, and everything's kind of getting so loose, and I can't do anything. I mean, so even if it's social, still we have to have some kind of connection, some kind of frame.
No.
So Svetlana seems to think different. So I said, okay, well, that doesn't work. School, Svetlana has her morning class, I have my morning classes, then we have ballet or morning technique at 10:30 till 12:30, then we go to other classes at the university, either dance or twice a week I have to go teach mathematics, calculus. We're usually trying to make our schedule so that we're done with the university around 4, sometimes 5, maybe 3, but around that time we can both arrange so we're free. We go straight to the studio. We have half an hour drive from the university to the studio through Wendy's or another hot dog place, so we grab it on the way, eat in the car usually, arrive, and then we practice. For us, we like the place. Big part of our life is happening there, actually. We practice there, we teach there, we have our studio there. It's a beautiful floor, it's one of the best in the city. It's very soft, as you saw. It's big enough, we can practice everything. I tend to like square arrangement. I think I don't like rectangles, so that works nicely. I like mirrors on both sides. I can see my students from any angle, and then there is a third side if you open the side doors. And I like atmosphere. It's kind of intimate. And again, Svetlana wouldn't agree with me, but I like that we don't have windows. I don't like windows.
I like windows.
To me, they're distracting. She likes light. Her name is Svetlana, which is in Russian means light.
Thank you.
Svetlana usually determined that the shoemakers made a mistake. They give her two pairs of identical shoes, same size, same heel, different color of the bottom. And Svetlana says one color fits her and the other doesn't. Everything is the same except the color of the bottom.
Yeah.
So we spent yesterday 3 hours in the shoe store.
Tap, tap, stitch and tap, making a pair of shoes. Le scarpine per ballare, ballare, balleremo tutto il dì. Le scarpine per ballare, ballare, balleremo ancor così. In the shoemaker's shop, this refrain would never stop as he tapped away, working all the day. At his bench there was he, just as busy as a bee. Little time to lose with the boots and shoes.
7 years? It's been about 7 years. Of course, we knew Igor first. Svetlana came over later. But we just loved him from day one.
But they loved me more after Svetlana came.
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, what do you mean? But they're nice people. They're good people.
Love it.
You love it?
Yes.
You can't get better than love it.
No.
She had come to choose some pretty dancing shoes, and he heard her say in a charming way, shoes to set my feet a-dancing, dancing, dancing, dancing all the day. Shoes to set my feet a-dancing, dancing, dancing all my cares away.
In Russia, we didn't have this luxury. We couldn't even dream about it. So we had to order the shoes. There was one man in whole Moscow who was making them, and most of the time he was drunk. So when he wasn't drunk, he was doing the job.
And he had to wait. Again.
You had, oh yeah, yeah.
Months?
Months. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
You I was waiting for my shoes.
Svetlana paid, somebody promised the shoes. She paid in advance. She never got them, and she never got the money back.
Right.
They were expensive. And they didn't have anything like this. There was, I don't know what they used. I think there was kind of mixture of leather and paper. I always thought it was paper, like more like box.
Then he tapped and he stitched, for his fingers were bewitched, and he sewed a dream into every seam. Making shoes, oh so neat, just like magic on her feet. And he hoped she'd know that he loved her so.
There's a lot involved in ballroom when it comes to competition. It's the lessons and the practice and the costumes and the shoes and makeup, then that's a whole other thing, isn't it? You get into all of, it's just a lot of things involved. It gets very involved.
Dancing all my cares away. All my cares away.
I was teaching the children in Russia. I was 20 by that time, and I was looking for the partner. I wasn't dancing because my height probably didn't allow me to find partner of the right size. Then one evening a lady came with a little girl and said she had a girl for my group club. Well, she said, I have a girl. And I said, well, we usually short on boys. I said, well, I mean a partner for yourself. I looked at the girl and said, well, you must be kidding. She's too small. But we tried and it worked out. It was really surprising. She agreed to dance with me. A few months later, she let me walk her to her house. A few months later, she let me into her apartment just once to say hi to her parents. And then we got married eventually. To man-woman relationship, as chauvinistic as that may sound, but the man should always look stronger, creating the illusion of taking care of the lady. I know a lot of people will not like this, but this is when ballroom looks its best.
I I was asking Igor, why you all the time make those decisions? Where to stand on the floor when we compete, or what to do, what I did wrong, why I cannot do this, why I cannot tell you what you did wrong. And then we had a lesson with the one guy, and he asked us to switch roles and ask me to be a man and him to be a lady. And it was so funny. When I get into this position, I was like, oh my God, I can see everything clear. I can see where to place couple, what Igor did wrong as a lady. So I can make those suggestions. So I think all position, ladies' position, are very weaker than the man's position in the couple. So it's just
kind of funny.
Yeah, of
course, the lady is hanging out there with the head out like that.
Yeah, and
how
like
can
I
she
cannot
make any decision? She's lucky if she can still breathe.
Yeah, good.
He's dominant in our partnership, so I like that a lot. The worst thing is sometimes his dominance is too much.
As we know, the moment she opens the mouth, the practice goes wrong. Again, that might be my bad quality. I don't like anybody contradicting me.
He is all the time teaching me, and he is not giving me time to actually think about it and do it and practice.
Svetlana needs to have this little push, let's say, into the rear to get her performing, and then she can. She can perform better than most people I've ever seen in my life.
He all the time wants to practice, and he all the time pushes me to practice, and even though he is tired or injured, he wants to spend his time on the dance floor.
What I do in math, and my field is geometry and topology, is probably the least applicable, least money-promising branch of mathematics. If I was doing statistics, yeah, I could be a millionaire by now.
This is my oldest dress that my mother made me when I was very young in Russia. So this is like, 10 years old now, and back in Russia we didn't have like all those rhinestones and feathers and fabrics, so we had to do something. So we were very creative.
I chose, and to me, the most beautiful piece of mathematics, geometry. And it is about shapes, kind of similar. We're dealing with shapes, and we could talk about transitions and actually what I deal with in my research, transformations of those shapes.
I want to talk about this dress.
Okay, talk about
this
whatever
is,
you want.
This is a...
I'll go.
Yeah, okay, this dress, I made... this is my first dress that I made. I mean, first ball gown. And I... This is my design too. So I like flowers, and I want to put it on the dress. And... And I didn't know where to get the flowers because no store carry flowers. So I bought, what is it? Flowers that you buy and you put it in a vase.
I sometimes I become too mathematical, analytical in my dance training. I had teachers yell at me because I want to know everything precisely. I think I'm changing lately. But it was a moment when I would know everything exactly the way it is. But again, such spheres like standard dancing, it's very geometrical, very physical. It's all about velocities and placement. So geometry comes in hand. Understanding this physics and mechanics of movement is very helpful. Then we have the physical qualities of the movement. So rumba would be, again, on top of the precision, where we have what we call foot speed, where the feet arrive very quickly on the floor with the beat, immediately, boom, on the floor. Then we have the fluid body mechanics, where the body has to feel the rest of the music. And just like in the music we dance to, we have two, at least two layers. We've got bass with the rhythm, the percussion, and then we've got the vocals or the melody. So we're trying to express in our bodies as much as we can of that music, because we dance to music. So for us, dancing really doesn't make much sense without music.
God gave them everything to love and hold each other like shelter from the rain. All through the night into the day, he never said he'd go away, but he did. And as she cried, I saw him just like you did that morning. That started and the feelings that they shared, like the wind beneath the dying sail, endlessly loving without fail. And he said that do was part of this side, swear to be there beside you.
I know how to prepare myself mentally for competitions. Some people like to be in the company around the people. I don't like people around me. I just go into myself and be there until I go to the floor.
Competitions. It's a love-hate relationship. Some people claim they love competitions, most people claim they don't like competitions, they still come, everybody comes, and everybody's happy when it's over. It's just a part of our system, it's part of the style we do, we can't get away from it. I really can't imagine ballroom dance on stage. I've seen it on stage and it doesn't really look good. Ballroom is better observed from all sides. And it does come out of social dance, so social atmosphere probably is a big part of it. So competitions tend to provide us with this atmosphere. We like competing, we like winning, we hate losing, so it's normal. Of course, I believe the competitions are the driving force. So I would assume in any art form or any dance style, there is a competition. For us, the final presentation is a competition. It's enjoyable, actually, and it makes us work harder. Get onto the floor to the moment we leave the floor. It's one big leap.
be in that mood. It's not cha-cha-cha, samba, rumba, but it is one dance with those five parts. So all this walking is you're still in focus, you're still dancing with your partner. That helps me to keep my energy in my body.
To the state where they can burst out extra energy, extra effort beyond their normal capabilities, but they can only sustain for little. So if we allow cha-cha-cha to be that moment, then the next four dances, samba, rumba, paso doble, jive, will be worth nothing. The energy will be down. So we have to make sure that we can sustain that moment of complete energy burst and explosion as long as possible. Announce the placement. It's the most difficult moment, especially if you care about it, because you don't know what's going to happen. I planned to finish university a long time ago, still there, but hopefully it comes to the close. We planned on moving to London a few years ago, still didn't. And actually the plans change. We no longer probably want to move there forever. We now, the older we become, the more we like Columbus. We would love to do something good without dancing. Go as far as we can possibly go, put as much as we can, because otherwise we'll never find out what is the potential. I'll tell you what my grandmother thinks we should do. She says I should be a professor. Absolutely, that's a must. I have to be a professor because everybody in family is. Svetlana should have a studio, she should own it, and I should work for her teaching lessons. Raising dancers is quite exciting. Taking children and seeing them grow and teaching them is very rewarding. I'm quite open to possibilities. I mean, it can go anyway. But right now, for the next few years, we plan on competing.